Good morning students. Chapter, study of the first element hydrogen, class 8. Before proceeding further, let's have a quick glance of our previous objective which you had done in the previous video. In the previous video, you were able to understand the position of hydrogen in the periodic table. Second, discovery of hydrogen. And the third one is occurrence of hydrogen in nature, means in free state as well as in combined state. Now, coming to topics for today. Today we are going to do similarity between hydrogen and alkali metals, means group 1 elements. Second, hydrogen and halogens, means group 17 elements. Now, open your concise books, page number 96-97. Now, before proceeding further, let's have the objective of the day. Today we are going to do that learn about the dual nature of hydrogen. Dual nature means the double nature of hydrogen. Since hydrogen resembles the alkali metal of group 1 as well as halogens of group 17 in some of its properties. So let's have the terminology, the terms related. First, alkali metals. Alkali metals are those elements which react with water to form hydroxides, or you can say water soluble bases. For example, first alkali metal we are going to take, that is sodium. That is, when sodium react with water, it forms sodium hydroxide with the release of hydrogen gas. Then potassium, when potassium reacts with water, it forms potassium hydroxide again with the release of hydrogen gas. Now coming to halogens. Halogens are actually group 17 elements. As they form salts when they react with metals, therefore they are called halogens. Actually, halogen word is derived from Greek word, which halo means salt and gens mean producing. So it means salt producing, or you can say salt former. So taking example of halogens, for example, fluorine, chlorine, when they react with sodium, means metals, they form salt, like sodium plus chlorine, sodium chloride, potassium plus chlorine, potassium chloride. While looking at the periodic table, you can see that hydrogen is placed amongst groups 1 element just above lithium because it has atomic number 1 here in group 1st, or simply you can say group 1. Group 1 is known as alkali metals, whereas halogens are placed exactly to the right side of extreme right side of that alkali metals, which is under 7th A, or you can say 17th group, 7th A according to old notion. Ever since the periodic table has formed, the position of hydrogen has been a debatable matter because some of its properties belong to properties of group 1 elements, which means alkali metals, here hydrogen where it is placed, and some of its properties belong to group 17 elements, means halogens. Therefore, hydrogen shows dual nature. Let's discuss first its similarities between alkali metals and hydrogen. Here are some of the properties of alkali metals which are similar to halogen. These properties are, for example, electronic configuration, valence electrons, valency, ion formation, reaction with air, combination with non-metals, or you simply say reaction with non-metals, and reducing agents. Now we are going to discuss each and every property one by one. Let's start with our first property, electronic configuration. Electronic configuration means the arrangement of electrons in the orbits of an atom, which you had earlier done in your previous video. Let's take example of group 1 elements. In group 1 elements, which you have seen in the periodic table, hydrogen, then lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium. Atomic number 1, 3, 11, 19 and 37 respectively. Now, when we arrange the electrons in their orbits, or simply you can say shells, since hydrogen has atomic number 1, it means it has only 1 electron. So, its electronic configuration is 1. It got only 1 shell. Coming to lithium, 2, 1. Sodium, since it has atomic number 11, so it has electronic configuration 2, 8, comma 1. Now, potassium, atomic number 19, electronic configuration 2, 8, comma 8, comma 1. Rubidium, atomic number 37, so electronic configuration is 2, comma 8, comma 18, comma 8, comma 1. It means you can see a similar trend at the end of the electronic configuration. Each element has only one electron in their last shell. Therefore, electronic configuration of alkali metals as well as halogens is similar because they both have one electron in their last shell. Now, coming to its second similarity, that is of valence electrons. Valence electrons means electrons present in the last shell, or simply you can say valence shell. Now, again, I'm coming to that chart. Here you can see each element, including even hydrogen, they all have one valence electron in their last shell. It means they all have one electron in their valence shell. Therefore, this property is also similar in between these two. Now, coming to the third similarity, that is valency. Valency is actually the combining capacity of an atom of an element. Let's take an example of sodium. Sodium has symbol Na and it has atomic number 11. While comparing similarity between sodium and hydrogen, here sodium has atomic number 11, so its electronic configuration is 2, 8, 1. Therefore, it can lose one electron and can acquire valency plus 1. Coming to hydrogen, hydrogen has atomic number 1, therefore its electronic configuration is also 1. It can also lose one electron and acquire valency plus 1. Now, coming to the fourth, that is ion formation. Before proceeding further, let's see what we mean by ion. Ions are actually the charged atoms are called ions, means they can have positive or negative charge. For example, if an element loses electron, it becomes cation, or you can say it becomes electropositive in nature. And if an element gains electron, it becomes anion, or simply you can say electronegative in nature. Now again, comparing the properties of sodium as well as hydrogen. First, sodium has atomic number 11, electronic configuration 2, 8, 1. Therefore, sodium can lose one electron and become electropositive, or sodium ion. Na minus one electron becomes sodium ion. Now hydrogen, atomic number 1, electronic configuration again 1. Therefore, it can also lose one electron and becomes cation or hydrogen ion. Other examples, let's take lithium. Lithium can lose one electron, therefore it becomes electropositive, that is lithium ion. Similarly with the potassium, by losing one electron, it can form K positive ion. Here is our fifth similarity between hydrogen and in alkali metals, that is reducing agents. So what are reducing agents? Reducing agents are actually those substances or agents which reduces other substance, either by providing electrons or by providing hydrogen or by removing oxygen. Let's take an example. For example, sodium loses electron, which means it reduces other substances by providing electron. Hence, both alkali metal as well as hydrogen act as reducing agent. Let's take some other examples. For example, copper oxide, when it reacts with hydrogen, hydrogen acts as reducing agent because it removes oxygen from here and forms copper plus water. Same with sodium. Sodium acts as reducing agent. It reduces copper oxide, changes it to copper and forms sodium oxide. Coming to our sixth property, that is action of air, or simply you can say combustion. So what is combustion? Combustion or burning actually. Combustion means the oxidation of a substance in the presence of air to release energy. So what's the similarity between when alkali metals react in the presence of air and hydrogen reacts in the presence of air? Again, we are going to take the example of sodium. Sodium, atomic number 11 and electronic configuration 281. When it reacts with sodium, it forms sodium oxide, which reacts vigorously in the presence of oxygen to form oxide. Similarly, hydrogen, when it reacts with oxygen, it forms water or dihydrogen oxide. It again reacts with hydrogen to form oxide and burns with pop sound. Now, coming to our seventh similarity, reaction with non-metals. How alkali metals as well as hydrogen both react with non-metals to form compounds. Non-metals are actually the elements which gain electron and acquire negative charge. For example, chlorine, fluorine, sulfur, nitrogen, etc. In case of alkali metals, they combine with certain non-metals to form their respective compounds. Let's take an example of sodium. Sodium combines with non-metals such as chlorine, sulfur and oxygen to form various compounds. For example, sodium on combining with chlorine forms sodium chloride, on combining with sulfur forms sodium sulfide, and on combining with oxygen forms sodium oxide. In similar pattern, when hydrogen combines with non-metals, it also forms certain compounds, like on combining with chlorine, it forms hydrogen chloride. Whereas on combining with sulfur, it forms hydrogen sulfide, and with oxygen, it forms dihydrogen oxide, or simply you can say water. Now, let's start with our next objective, mean similarities between properties of halogens and hydrogen. Here are some of the properties of halogen elements, mean group 17 elements, which are similar to properties of hydrogen. Let's have a quick glance of those properties. First is electronic configuration, second valency, third one is ion formation, fourth one atomicity, and the last one is physical state. Now we are going to start with the next objective, similarities between halogens and hydrogen. First property which is similar between halogens and hydrogen is again electronic configuration, which means distribution of electrons in the orbits or shells. Here K, L, M represent shells. So we have taken elements hydrogen, fluorine and chlorine, symbol H, F and Cl respectively. They are having atomic number hydrogen 1, fluorine 9 and chlorine 17. So while making their electronic configuration, since hydrogen has atomic number 1, it means it has only one electron. Therefore its electronic configuration is 1. Fluorine 2,7 because it has 9 electrons. Chlorine 17 means 2,8,7. So what's the similarity between these three elements? Actually, they all have, means halogens and hydrogen, just one electron short of their inert gas. Let's take an example of hydrogen. Hydrogen is just one electron short of helium, which has atomic number 2. Fluorine, it has one electron short of neon, which has atomic number 10. And chlorine, which is one electron short of argon gas, which has electronic configuration 288, means atomic number 18. Now, coming to our next property, that is valency, means combining capacity of an atom of an element. Now, what's the similarity between halogen and hydrogen? So, halogen, we are going to take the example of chlorine. Chlorine has atomic number 17. It means it has electronic configuration 2,8,7. Therefore, it can gain one electron and become electronegative to complete its shell. Similarly, in the case of hydrogen, it has atomic number 1. It has electronic configuration 1. As similar to halogen, it can also gain one electron and become anion, or you can say electronegative. Next property is ion formation. Ion means atoms with having charges, means positive ion or negative ion. Both halogens as well as hydrogen can form anion by gaining electron, which you have seen earlier. Now halogen, let's take an example of chlorine again. Chlorine, symbol Cl, it has atomic number 17, electronic configuration 2,8,7. So it can gain one electron and become anion, means Cl plus one electron form Cl minus one. Whereas in the case of hydrogen, symbol H, atomic number 1, electronic configuration 1, means it belongs to only K shell, it can gain one electron and become H minus 1. It means they both have tendency to gain electron and hence have electronegative character. The fourth similarity between halogens as well as in hydrogen is their physical state. We all know that there are three states of matter, that is solid, liquid and gaseous state. Some of the halogens like fluorine and chlorine exist in gaseous state. So as hydrogen means H2 gas. Now let's talk about fifth similarity between halogen and hydrogen is atomicity. So atomicity is the number of atoms in the molecule of an element. Both hydrogen as well as halogens are diatomic in nature, which means having atomicity 2. For example, hydrogen exists in H2, means diatomic state, fluorine as F2, chlorine Cl2, bromine Br2, iodine I2. Till now, we have discussed only the similarities of hydrogen element with alkali metal and halogens. Now, let's talk about some of the properties of hydrogen which are differ from those of alkali metal as well as hydrogen. Or simply we can say dissimilarities of hydrogen with alkali metals and halogens. So in case of alkali metals, they don't have only one shell, they have more than one shell. Similarly, in the case of halogens, they have more than one shell. But in the case of hydrogen, it contains only one shell, that is K shell, because it has atomic number 1. Lithium with atomic number 3 has got two shells. Sodium, atomic number 11, it has got three shells. Whereas in case of halogen, let's take an example of fluorine. It has atomic number 9. It means it has two shells, K and L. Whereas chlorine, having atomic number 17, it has three shells, K, L and M. Now coming to second dissimilarity, that is oxides. In case of oxides of hydrogen, it will form neutral oxides. That is, water is a neutral oxide. It means it does not give any test with litmus paper. Whereas in the case of alkali metals, they form oxides which are basic in nature. For example, Na2O, sodium oxide, K2O, potassium oxide, which are basic in nature. It means they will turn red litmus paper to blue. In case of halogens, their oxides are acidic in nature. For example, Cl2O, which is acidic in nature, and it will turn blue litmus paper to red. Now, open your chemistry concise book, page number 96. Here in the pink box under heading note, here hydrogen shows a dual nature, means double nature, since it resembles the alkali metals of group 1A, simply you can say group 1, and the halogens of group 7A or group 17. Under heading 6.2, similarities between hydrogen and alkali metals. First property of the similarity is electronic configuration, which means the distribution of electrons in the orbits. They have only one electron in their outermost orbits. So you can see the similarity as hydrogen, lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium and francium. They all have only one electron in their last shell. Now coming to second property, that is valence electrons. Valence electrons means electron present in the last shell. All elements, means elements of alkali metal as well as hydrogen, they have one electron in their outermost orbit, that is their valency shell, and so all of them have only one valence electron. Now coming to valency. Valency means the combining capacity of an atom of an element. So all alkali metals including hydrogen have valency 1. Now ion formation. Each of them can form cation, that is positive ion, by loss of an electron. Here hydrogen by losing one electron form H positive, lithium by losing one electron Li positive, and similar is the case of sodium by forming Na positive. As Such, all these elements have electropositive character. Now coming to reducing part. Both the alkali metals and hydrogen act as reducing agents. It means they can provide electron or they can remove oxygen. Here copper oxide plus hydrogen gives copper plus hydrogen, dihydrogen oxide means water, by removing oxygen. Similarly, sodium, it acts as reducing agent by removing oxygen from copper oxide and forming sodium oxide. Now next property is burning. Burning means combustion. Hydrogen burns in oxygen to form its oxide, that is H2O, which is dihydrogen oxide. Hydrogen burns with a pop sound. Similarly is the case of alkali metals. They also burn vigorously when heated in oxygen to form their respective oxide. For example, lithium forms lithium monoxide, that is Li2O. Sodium, on reacting with sodium oxide, it will form sodium oxide or sodium peroxide. Now, as we know that alkali metals react vigorously in the presence of air, therefore alkali metals are usually kept under kerosene oil. Now here under the heading note, due to their reactivity, alkali metals are always stored in an inert organic solvent such as kerosene oil. This inert solvent prevents them from coming in contact with air and moisture. Otherwise, they will catch fire. Now, next is combination with non-metals, or you can say reaction with non-metals. Hydrogen as well as alkali metals react with non-metals like oxygen, sulfur and chlorine to form respective compounds. Example, hydrogen forms H2O with oxygen. With sulfur, it forms H2S. And with chlorine, it will form HCl. Sodium, it forms Na2O, sodium oxide with oxygen, Na2S, sodium sulfide with sulfur, and NaCl means sodium chloride with chlorine. Now, similarities between hydrogen and halogens. First, again, electronic configuration. Hydrogen and halogens have one electron less than their nearest inert gas. Hydrogen, fluorine, and chlorine, they all have only one electron short of their nearest noble gas, such as hydrogen is from helium, fluorine from neon, and chlorine from argon. Now valency, both have valency 1, means both halogens as well as hydrogen can gain electron and will acquire valency minus 1. Thus, they accept one electron to attain the electronic configuration of the nearest inert gas. Now coming to formation of ions or ion formation, both show a tendency to form anions, means negatively charged ions, since they are one electron short of the nearest inert gas configuration. Now next is electronegative character. Both halogens and hydrogen are non-metal. They show electronegative character. It means by gaining electron and acquiring negative charge. Physical state, like halogens such as fluorine and chlorine, hydrogen too is a gas, which is actually diatomic in nature. Atomicity, hydrogen as well as halogens exist in the form of diatomic molecules H2, F2, Cl2, Br2 and I2. Now, let's now discuss some of the properties of hydrogen which are differ from those of alkali metals and halogens, because earlier we have discussed only similarities between these two. First is, hydrogen atom has only one shell, that is K shell, but alkali metals and halogens both have two or more shells. Second, oxides of hydrogen, that is H2O, or you can say water, is a neutral oxide, whereas oxides of halogens like Cl2O, Cl2O7, etc. are acidic in nature. And while oxides of alkali metals like Na2O, K2O, etc. are basic in nature.